inside his own five. He was looking for some running room and not much to be found as he stopped at the 18.
First down, they'll snap it from the 32. The RPO, fire complete to the left. And he goes out of bounds after coming up with positive yardage there.
Nice job there. Good timing between the QB and the wide receiver executing that out.
Kept it on the ground on first down, now back to the line.
Good pick. Good pick.
What a great play by the defense and paying it off with the interception return.
You always want to come out and set the tone as a defense. Get a stop, make a punt. How about this? Get the INT and take it back to the house. Way to set the tone for this defense here.
They'll try to add another to their lead. And he's got the extra point, and it's 7-0 to start this one. They'll kick it off and send that defense right back out there to try to score again after the pick six. No return coming. He'll call for the fair catch.
Took advantage of it, but you got to put it behind you. Jesse, I'm sure you know a thing or two about throwing a pick six and how to rebound.
I believe I've only thrown one in my life, but yes, I do, because of that singular instance. I'll say this. You can't let that play beat you twice. You got to go out, not try to get it all back here in one play. Just execute the offense.
Quickly complete. And he's got enough for the first down. It'll be at the 35. Precision, execution, and timing to pick up the first down on the out route.
I think you're spot on. Those out routes, man, it's got to be about timing. You got to throw that football before he breaks. Nice job seeing it. Short yard situation. Throw the ball on the money so the receiver can get upfield and get the first down.
Stopped after making the catch.
You know, that play right there shows me the quarterback has a plan. He had no hesitation. The defense was bearing down on him. He got hit on that play, but he knew where his running back was. He got it out to him quick. And as a result, he avoided the negative.
Still some work to do after that last completion at second down. The throw to the outside is complete. And he'll step out of bounds after a very productive play.
Really good offenses are able to attack short. You've got to be able to attack the whole field to make you honor that underneath part, then the intermediate part, and then you take shots down the field. This will loosen up some shots for later in the game.
Can't make the connection on third down thanks to that tough, hard-nosed pass defense, and now it's fourth down.
Defense did a great job. Third and short on the opponent's side of the field. They're expecting quick throw. Everybody, they dug their heel on the ground. They're able to break on the ball and force the incompletion.
The completion well past the sticks. Can anyone catch it? Touchdown, Bucs! And once he found some daylight, it was time to make a house call.
And man, that play looked a little bit too easy. Fourth down, big situation. You got to get up on these receivers and make it difficult. He gets the football right away, gets all the way to the end zone for the touchdown.
And we're all square as he's set to kick it away. Bounces through the end zone. It's a touchback. They'll bring it out to the 25. Here's this offense with a fresh set of downs. Defense playing a bail technique. Wants to throw on first down. They're trying to get to it. And he just chucks it into the fourth row.
So he's outside the tackle box. He knew he could throw it away as long as he got it past the line of scrimmage. Nothing there, nothing open. Live to fight another down.
That's it, fly. Makes the grab. Really good job to pick up a chunk of yardage and get it out to the 39-yard line. The evolution of the Alabama offense has always been built around what does the quarterback do best, and this guy's doing a lot of things well.
And we've seen some sensational ones. And to your point, I like that. Jalen Hurts, really good runner. They built it around his feet. You know, Bryce Young, really good passer. Tua Tagovailoa, really good passer. More about the passing game, explosive passing play. So they'll do whatever it takes to win.
Alabama with a first and 10 here. Corners right up on that line of scrimmage. It's Milroe. Wide open downfield. He goes to the ground, but not before a big pickup and a first down. Linebackers moving, trying to confuse the quarterback. Start the drive here with first down to open this period. The back goes in motion. Trying to find his man on first down. Quarterback floating away from pressure. On the run, and he'll slide to avoid the big hit.
Nice job by the QB. Sit back in the pocket. You can tell he wants to throw the football, go through his progressions. Nothing home. Take off and slide. I love the slide hand. Don't take a big shot.
They'll run play action. Dances away from the heat. He's in a world of trouble, and down he goes. A catastrophic loss on that play. This is a third and long. Looking to throw, and he needs a bunch. Coming after it. And this defense goes back to back.
You better kick it, bro.
And I just love the defense right now and the effort they're showing. Two straight plays and two straight sacks. That's just dudes up front winning their
right.
Oh, a big decision here early as they leave the offense on the field in their own territory. They want to keep this opening drive alive. One to the left. Heaves it into trouble, and he finds trouble with the pick. Got room on the return. And a big return after the INT sets up the offense for this possession. They'll open this drive and snap it from the 44. Here's a quick throw out to the left. Oh, he ruins the pick.
Oh, my goodness.
And the defense got it.
These wide receivers are so fast nowadays. They're such big playmakers. I just want to get to them and let them make it happen. But a lot of times, we're running to them, too. We're focused on chasing it down and funneling the football in the right direction. Defense swarm did a good job getting their hand on the football, causing the fumble for the wide receiver.
Catch in the middle. It's Henderson. Put it right on him. Sweet play. Good pickup. up and they'll move the chains with the first down. New set of downs after that completion. Going up top on first down. That's reeled in. It's Haynes.
Nice patience by the quarterback here, working against zone coverage. He was allowing his receiver an opportunity to find that open space in the defense before pulling the trigger.
Back to throw, it's Milroe. Getting some heat. Nowhere close on that one as he got drilled trying to deliver the football, and now they face third down.
The offensive line has got to give him at least a little bit of time to survey the field. He had no chance that time, getting hit almost immediately after he got the ball.
Catch in the middle, it's Henderson. Really nice pickup on that one as they get it to the 36. It'll be first down. And now a fresh set of downs for this offense. They'll throw it on first down. Can't find his man as he took a shot trying to deliver that football, and it'll be second down. Couldn't make the connection last time. Let's see if they throw it again. On second down, they'll take to the air. Still looking, on the move. Gets away from one. Across the 25, he's got room. How about that nice run from this junior quarterback?
These guys aren't humane. I mean, they got to survey the field, throw the football, make deep passes, and then guess what else? They pull the ball down, take off, and make big chunks of plays on the ground. It's just impossible to be on defense nowadays.
And with not much doing downfield, he found his parents open in the stands and threw it to them.
A nice job by the quarterback there. You're outside the pocket, nobody's open, so you throw the ball away knowing that you still have more chances to get this first down.
He's going to pass on second down. Pressure in his face and he lets it fly. And that pass is intercepted. Taking it the other way. He's at the 20. And he's going to take it all the way. Touchdown, Buffalo! Lining up to tack one more onto that lead. And the extra point is true, and they're on top by 7. So here comes the kickoff after the touchdown, and the last thing you need right
before
the half is to give up a big return. It bounds through the back of the end zone, and it'll be a touchback. Time dwindling away as they try to put points on the board right before the half. Wants to throw on first down off the play fake. He lofts it high and deep down the left side. And it slips through his fingers, incomplete. That would have been a huge game if he could have held on.
Dang it, brother. What's going on?
You got to give the defense tons of credit because we know how much speed this quarterback has. That time you saw the pursuit and were able to bring him down for a big loss on the sack.
Got it in the middle, it's Henderson. Slicing and dicing through this defense and they've got it down to the 23.
Okay. good. It's all good. What the fuck?
Just about ready to kick it away. He'll call for the fair catch here. start the drive after the break. Pulled it, finds his man on the left. Ripping off a pretty good chunk of yardage. They've got it out to the 41 with the first down. The Buffaloes are in the hurry up. Grab behind the line, it's Hunter. And a 9-yard gain on first down leaves him with second and short.
I think this receiver's forte is his route running. He's a guy that can line up all over the field, but it's not just catching post routes or goes. This guy can run shallows, he can run slants, he can run the option routes and find soft spots in the defense. This guy really has all the routes in his toolbox.
That pass is incomplete, and they're probably fortunate that it wasn't knocked free for a fumble. Third down and one, and this is why they call it a gut check. Quick pass to the left, trying to get it to the marker. He steps out of bounds, but it will be enough for a first down. We asked earlier this week, who's your favorite receiver? And of course, he said the open one, but we know who he really wants to go to on third down.
The best one. I think the open one, obviously, the politically correct answer. But you want to find the guy that you've got that great chemistry with. You know exactly where he's going to be. You got that bond and that trust.
As they couldn't connect, it's second and 10. To the air, it's Sanders. Receiver looks it in, it's complete. And chunk plays are the name of the game, and they get one here before the defense finally makes a stop.
And that's the danger. You've got a receiver like that. If you blitz and you're playing man coverage, he's one-on-one, and he's going to burn you if you don't get home to the quarterback.
We've reached a 2-minute warning, and the defense needs to come up with a stop to close this thing out. In search of that tying touchdown, they've moved the chains a couple of times. It's first and 10 again. Looking to throw it again. They'll run the screen. He'll get it all the way down to the 8-yard line, and the defense is feeling the heat.
Hey, man, sometimes you get the perfect play call at the perfect time. That time, the defense blitzing, offensive line allowed everybody to run upfield, and they slip in the running back screen, and behind it, there was nobody there to make a tackle, and this offense generates a massive play.
Keeping it on the ground on first and goal. And maybe he'll get back to the line of scrimmage, but no more than that.
Well, they're trying to run the football there, just nowhere to go. They got dominated up front at the point of attack.
Defense rolls up deep in its own end on that last play. Now a second and long coming.
That is how it's done late in the football game. Now, all you need is that extra point. Bring the kicker out there. This is what you do. Just like practice, knock it through the uprights, tie this football game, and we might be looking at overtime soon.
Quick timeout call by the offense after the play, trying to preserve every minute possible. Now the two-point conversion attempt is coming. To throw, it's Sanders. He gets it into the end zone, and the two-point conversion is good, and the gamble gives him the lead by one. Almost ready to kick it away after scoring the touchdown. He'll take take a knee. It's a touchback save every second he can as they try to put together this final drive. Here comes that Alabama offense. After standing on the sideline and watching that long touchdown drive, they really need to put something together. And he can't find anyone open, and down he goes. A sack here late in the fourth. They immediately call timeout, trying to preserve every second they can to try to rally here late. The defense calls the timeout, their second of the day, as they try to get their act together. Remember, all they have to do is get it close enough for a field goal here. On second down, wants to throw. They're bringing heat. And the pressure will get there. The sack. Down he goes in the waiting moments. That could be a costly play. They've got to move quickly here. Still a chance, but they've got to force the ball down the field. The quarterback can make a big play when he starts moving around. That pass is well. He got hit as he was trying to throw, and they can't convert on
the ball. GG's, bro.
Well, they're trailing in this game late. The defense knows it, so they're playing for pass. Two plays ago, they get the sack. This time, they force an incompletion. Not a lot the offense can do here to catch them off guard. They're just going to have to make a huge play here on fourth down.
He's going to let one fly down the middle. It's incomplete, and they
GG's, bro.